Welcome to Electrical Lad, your go-to place for breaking down electrical concepts in a simple and practical way. If you're new here, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss future videos. Now let's get started. In this video, we'll explore the essential components involved in controlling a 30 horsepower, 22 kW, three-phase motor. We'll break it down into two main sections, the 480-volt power side and the 110-volt AC control side. You'll learn about main breakers, motor starters, overload protection, latching circuits, and we'll walk through both the electrical and wiring diagrams. Let's begin with the 480-volt side, where the system gets its power. First, you'll need a main circuit breaker. This breaker protects the entire system from overcurrent and short circuits. The breaker size usually falls between 125 and 200% of the motor's full load current. You can check the motor's nameplate for the full load amps or look it up in the Ugly's Electrical References book. For our setup, we're going with 200% of the FLA, which works out to 80 amps. Next, let's go over the motor starter. Before we dive in, do me a quick favor. Hit that like button, subscribe, and tap the bell icon. To start a three-phase motor, all three phases need to be powered simultaneously, and that's where a motor starter comes into play. It has three contacts that close at the same time to send power to the motor. The motor starter also includes overload protection. If the motor draws too much current, beyond the set limit, the overload protection trips, cutting off power to prevent motor damage.
Don't set the overloads too high.
Never exceed 125% of the motor's full load current. For a 40 horsepower motor, this means the setting should be no higher than 50 amps. But how does a motor starter work? First, the motor starter contains three sets of contacts that deliver power to the motor. Each set of contacts consists of a stationary and a movable contact. The movable contacts are attached to the coil with non-conductive materials, like fiberglass or reinforced molded plastic. The coil typically consists of three main components: an iron core, a main coil, and springs. When the correct voltage, 120 volts AC in this case, is applied to the coil, it creates a magnetic field that draws in the iron core. This movement closes the contacts, enabling power to pass through them and the overload elements, which energizes the motor. The motor continues running until power is removed from the coil. Before we get into the 120 volt AC control side, we need to talk about two other components on the starter, the auxiliary contact and the overload contact. These will play a key role in the start-stop control circuit. The auxiliary contact is connected to the main contactor and closes at the same time. It's mainly used in the control circuit to show when the contactor is activated. It also helps latch the circuit, but I'll explain that in more detail when we get to the control circuit. An overload contact is a normally closed contact that opens when an overload occurs and needs to be manually reset using a reset button. In the control circuit, it disconnects the circuit when an overload is detected. Now let's take a look at the control circuit for our 30 horsepower motor. In its simplest form, the motor control circuit will look like this. The first component in our control circuit is the control transformer, which has primary and secondary fuses. It steps down the voltage from 480 volts to 120 volts AC, supplying power to the entire control circuit. The next set of components includes the momentary start and stop buttons. Notice the term momentary. This means the buttons are only active while being pressed. Once you release them, they return to their normal state. The stop button is normally closed, meaning it allows current to flow until pressed. The start button, on the other hand, is normally open and only completes the circuit when you press it. The next three components in the circuit are all part of the motor starter. First is the starter coil, labeled M1. Then, there's the auxiliary contact of the starter, and lastly, the normally closed overload contact. So, how does this circuit work? Let's go through that next. If you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and give us a thumbs up. A motor starter control circuit uses what's known as a latching circuit. A latching circuit keeps the motor starter energized even after the initial start signal is removed. It works by using one of the motor starter's normally open auxiliary contacts, which is wired in parallel with the start button. When you press the start button, it energizes the M1 coil, closing the auxiliary contact. This contact then continues to supply power to the coil even after you release the start button. The motor starter coil stays energized, or latched, until you press a separate stop button, which is wired in series with the circuit. Additionally, the coil will de-energize if an overload contact trips, cutting off the power. Now, if you want a pilot light to show that the motor is running, you can connect it in parallel with the motor starter coil. Let's take a look at the entire motor circuit. Notice that the step-down control transformer is connected to two legs of the 480-volt supply. And there you have it. We've walked through the components, diagrams, and calculations necessary to set up a motor control system for a 30-horsepower motor, 22 kW. Understanding these basics can make a huge difference in building safe and reliable circuits. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, share it with your colleagues, and don't forget to subscribe for more in-depth electrical tutorials. If you have any questions about this motor control circuit, feel free to ask them in the comments. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.